His dream haunts me in my nightmares. All he ever wanted was for his only son to be a champion like he was. My mum died before I even had the chance to create a memory of her. He raised me the only way he knew how, in the gym, with blood, sweat and tears. Through every age group, I collected countless trophies. This made my dad as proud as a father can be. But I didn't share his happiness. More and more, I could feel myself drifting in another direction. I studied hard, and my qualifications allowed me to go to university. Dad didn't see the point. He thought I should be turning pro, devoting myself full time to a career inside the ring. But I'd met a girl. The fighting scared her. I loved her, and it hurt to see her upset. As a teenager, all I knew outside of school was training. Even when we couldn't train in the gym, we'd spend countless hours in the garden just throwing punches over and over till I couldn't keep my hands up anymore. He'd let me wear his championship robe, and in that moment, I felt like I was a champion. So I chose another life. I would go to university, and this meant I had to leave the gym and my prospects as a fighter behind. Three years later, I received the call to tell me my father had passed away. He'd just been lying there, inside his flat, alone, for weeks. No one even noticed he was gone. My father, the champion, reduced to a nobody, dying alone in a run-down flat. My fault. My decision that led him to this pitiful end. I'd tried to contact him at first, but he couldn't bring himself to forgive me, and I gave up. Why did I give up? He loved me as much as a father can love his son. I could have convinced him before he was lost. The guilt and pain burns in my heart, and I can't move on. There's only one thing I can do for him now. One way to find redemption for both of us. I have to get back in the gym, and I have to fight. My only happy memories, the only time I didn't feel pressure and pain, was when we would fish together beside the waterfall. This is the only place I can feel close to him. Before I told my dad that I wasn't going to fight, we drank together for the last time, and we shared our last smile in a photograph. He was devastated. There was a massive argument, and he stormed out. It was the last time I saw him alive. I have to be that for him. I'm his legacy now. One fight for him. A pro fight that he's dreamed of since the day I was born. I can only hope that in this war, I can bring both of us peace.